Hello all, and welcome back. In this session, we will talk about SAP Fiori. So, we understood that there are three key enablers of SAP S/4HANA. First one is SAP HANA as a database, which is providing the speed. Second one was SAP Fiori, which is providing the better user interface. Why exactly do we need the better user interface? The answer is we are using the traditional screens of SAP. So let's take an example of creating the purchase order, or let's take an example of booking the normal FI invoice. So we are using these traditional screens from years. While the market is changing and even a small shopkeeper is also having the app through which customers can order their goods. So why not SAP? Why SAP is not supporting the transactions which can be accessed from anywhere, the transactions which you can do it from your mobile device, from tabs? So this was one of the requirements from the customers, because even a small children today, they know how to operate the normal apps on mobiles. Due to that reason, SAP has came up with a new user interface called as SAP Fiori. Using SAP Fiori, you can perform your transactions, you can display your reports with a very simplified user experience, and which can be operated from any device. So it can be, you can perform your transactions from a mobile device, you can perform your transactions from tabs, or maybe laptops and computers are still available. So SAP Fiori is going to be the future of user interface from SAP point of view. So in SAP S/4HANA, SAP Fiori is by default available. We are not saying that the traditional SAP screens are not available. They are still available. But going forward, maybe 2-3 years down the line, everybody will be using SAP Fiori and there will not be any need of using the traditional SAP screens. From the consultant point of view, as of today also, not all the configurations can be done from SAP Fiori. So as a consultant, we still need to use SPRO screens to perform the configuration, at least if you are using on-premise system. Because in on-cloud, there are some Fiori apps with which you can configure the system without touching SPRO, because SPRO is not the recommended way, or it is not available at all when you go for the cloud. We will discuss about private versus cloud later on, but just keep one thing in mind that from the on-premise point of view, if you want to perform the configuration, you can still access SPRO, because all configurations are not supported on SAP Fiori. Now, in this picture, you can see what SAP Fiori is providing. On the left hand side, you can see SAP Fiori allows us to create the new applications. So there are some new applications which are already created. For example, the reports, the fact sheets, which were never available in the traditional SAP system, are available via SAP Fiori. There are some applications which are renewed. What do you mean by renewed? Renewed means you are able to create a purchase order using the traditional screen. Now, using SAP Fiori screens, these screens are simplified, so they are renewed. And finally, enable. Enable means SAP has created some new application, SAP has provided some renewed applications, but still, as a customer, there may be the requirement which is specific to your business, which is not provided by SAP. And you want to create your own custom Fiori app to meet that requirement. So enable means SAP also provides you the tool using which you can create your own Fiori apps. The design principles, like how exactly SAP Fiori is better, because it is role-based. The first feature is role-based. What do you mean by role-based now? So if I show you the Fiori screen, which I'll show you just after this theoretical discussion, In the Fiori screen, you can see the different transactions, different reports available in your launchpad. Launchpad means as soon as you log in into SAP Fiori, the first screen that you see is the boxes with different transactions. Now, as we know, there may be thousands of transactions which are available in SAP. If I show you all those thousands of transactions in your Fiori launchpad, you will not be happy and you will be confused which one is related to me. So for example, if I'm a purchasing manager, when I log in to my SAP Fiori screen, I should be only able to see the Fiori apps for which I am authorized or they have something to do with me. I should not be able to see the app like create sales order because I'm not responsible for that particular activity. So what SAP has done is they, for each and every Fiori app, they created a role, and within role there can be multiple apps which are assigned to it. So for my user ID, if I'm a purchasing manager, I will make sure that the role related to purchasing manager is assigned to me so that I can only see the apps which are relevant to purchase manager. Similarly, for sales manager, there will be some other apps. There may be some other role which is created, which will be assigned to his user ID. Second is responsive. Now, responsive simply means it can be accessed from any device. You can access it from mobile, you can access it from tab, you can access it from laptops, computer, any device and from anywhere. Obviously, they are simple to use. The third one is simple. They are simple to use compared to the traditional screens. Coherent means it is same. The look and feel is same irrespective of which application you are using. And finally, it provides you the delightful experience. Okay, because it is speaking your language, which means if you are a purchasing manager, if it is only showing you the apps which are relevant to you, if it is also, you can also do this any from anywhere, from any device. So definitely you will be delighted to see this new screens compared to the traditional screens that we were using. So this is how exactly the difference is. So for example, earlier there was one transaction and there were multiple roles. Let's take an example of creation of vendor. So when we were creating the vendor in SAP ECC system, one person was responsible for the general segment. Second person was responsible to create the purchase organization segment. And normally the finance department was responsible to create the company code segment. But the screen was same. Same transaction like XK01, XK02, XK03 was used to access that vendor master data. Here in SAP Fiori, there are three different apps. So one app to just create a vendor master. This is just an example. I'm not saying that this is specific to vendor. I'm talking about the general information that why they created role based. Okay, so one person who is responsible for entering the general data, he will be provided with a different app. The person who is responsible for maintaining the purchasing organization data, he will get to see his second app. And the third one, the company code information, will be entered by the financial team. Okay, other important thing you can see here is if you are using two components, let's say you are using CRM and ERP. In that case, every time whenever you want to shuffle between ERP and CRM, you need to come out of this and you need to go into the CRM application. Again, once you completed CRM task, you'll again shuffle back to ECC system. But here in SAP Fiori, there will be one common screen. Okay, there are a lot of apps which SAP has provided. When you are responsible for maintaining both the systems, so let's say you are maintaining some master data in which half of the master data belongs to ECC and half of the master data is actually stored in CRM. So you don't need to shuffle between two things. One single app will allow you the fields relevant to CRM and also the fields relevant to your core ERP system. So this is providing you one entry point. You don't need to shuffle between the screens. So that is another benefit of SAP Fiori. this is just an example. So how these traditional screens are looking and how exactly SAP Fiori screens will look like. We will see practically. I'll show you some of the transactions when we are going to do some processes like general ledger accounting. What are the different Fiori apps available? How you can access those apps? How can you do the transactions using those Fiori apps? So that is something that we will discuss. But this is just an example where you can see how this new Fiori screens are different compared to the traditional screens. Now, within the Fiori launchpad, when you log in, again, let's take an example of same purchasing manager, or let's take an example of purchasing requisitioner or maybe a purchasing department who are responsible to create the purchase order. So if I am responsible to create a purchase order, as soon as I log into the system, I should be able to see create purchase order transaction, create purchase order app. So that app belongs to this criteria. It belongs to this group, transactional, or this belongs to that this type, transactional app, which means it is allowing you to perform the transaction. Analytical is some kind of report. So you want to see how many orders are placed for this particular vendor. So that is analytics. And third one is the fact sheet, which is allowing you to do some decisions. Let's take an example of approval. Let's take an example of purchasing analytics, where you are looking at top 10 customers or top 10 suppliers. And again, you are clicking into it and it is allowing you to do multiple decisions. So that kind of apps are called as fact sheets. So normally as a business user, we will be using transactional and analytical apps, while fact sheets, there will be minimum of fact sheets, and that is something which is allowing you to do the decision making. So again, let me clarify one thing. This is one of the questions that my student asked. Is SAP Fiori only available on SAP S/4HANA? Or it can be accessed from SAP ECC also, or it can be activated on SAP ECC also. The answer is SAP Fiori was developed around 3-4 years back, and it can be also accessed from ECC. Even today also, if you are using ECC system and if you are interested in SAP Fiori apps, you can go for SAP Fiori activation. But at the same time, if you are using SAP Fiori on ECC system, it will only allow you some basic of transactions. It will not allow you to see any reports. It will not allow you to see any fact sheets. Only transactional apps. Again, not all transactional apps. Only few transactional apps are available for the customers who want to use SAP Fiori on ECC system. Because this analytical and fact sheets app are totally based on SAP HANA database, and that is the reason they are only supported in SAP S/4HANA. So even if you are using SAP HANA on ECC system, there will be a lot of restrictions when it comes to analytical and fact sheets. So in short, analytical and fact sheets, they will work only on HANA database, while transactional apps can work even on ECC also. Now, based on the requirement of the customer, if there are thousands of Fiori apps, let's say, for example, there are the apps relevant to production planning. There are some apps relevant to materials management, sales and distribution. Now, again, based on the requirements of the customer, it may happen that the company is not into manufacturing, so they don't want to use the apps which are related to production planning. So based on the requirement only, you will be activating the app. You need to identify what apps are required and to whom are you going to assign these apps. So it is actually not your responsibility to activate the apps, but I'll just try to make you understand from where exactly these Fiori apps are activated. So each and every Fiori app is actually created in the technology called as UFI, the designing or the format designing of the Fiori app is done in the technology called as UFI. But whenever you do any transaction, in the background, it calls a particular service. You must be aware of SICF, where you can activate the services. So for each and every Fiori app, there is a corresponding service which is being called in the background. And if that service is not activated, even if you are able to see the Fiori app, if you click on that, system will throw error message that this service is not activated. So in order to activate that service, you will be going to SICF. Again, as a functional consultant, normally you will not do this. You will ask your Fiori consultant to do it. Okay. And if you want to maintain the service, let's say maintaining the new service and all, then you will be going to this transaction. And finally, if you want to make sure that a particular Fiori app is available to the particular user, you definitely need to assign the corresponding role to that user. If the role is not assigned, user will not be able to see that particular app under its launchpad. Okay, so these are the three things that are required in order to make sure that the user is able to do the transactions from the SAP Fiori app. First of all, user must be assigned to the particular role, and that service must be maintained and activated using these two transactions. Now, if you want to know what are the different SAP Fiori apps available as of today, or maybe in future, if you want to know how can I access which SAP Fiori app is available to create a purchase order. So in that case, SAP has provided this link. If you click on this link, it will take you to SAP Fiori library. This is called as SAP Fiori app library. And there you will be able to see all the different kind of apps which are available with lot of further details. Let me open this. So this is a link which I just shown you. If you go to this link, you will be able to see SAP Fiori apps for SAP S/4HANA. Once you click here, it will show you the apps by these groups. So you can select a particular role. It will show you all the Fiori apps which are available for the particular role. So for example, if I click on this, as I told you, each and every Fiori app is role based. So let's say accounts payable accountant, accounts payable accountant for Japan. So this is something which is country specific. This is accounts payable accountant for procurement. Okay, so these are the kind of different roles. So if you want to find out what Fiori apps are available for the particular role, you will click here and it will open all the corresponding Fiori apps. If you go back, there are further criteria like lines of business, industry, application component and all. But let's make it simple. If you want to know which Fiori app is available for creation of purchase order or let's say creation of invoice. So I'll click on this all apps. And here is a search button, search field. If I enter create, even first you try this create purchase order and press enter. Okay. The other way is you can enter the transaction code if you remember. Okay, so manage purchase order, for example. So this is a corresponding app which is available in SAP S/4HANA to create the purchase orders. This is just an example. You can enter various transactions, whatever you want, and it will give you the corresponding SAP Fiori app. Now, if you want to know more details about this, you click on this particular app. It will show you all the technical details which are relevant to this app. So for example, it is telling you under which version this app is available, whether this is available only on premise or it is also available on cloud. It is also giving you the different features, like it is saying you what exactly you can do by using this app. Okay. And the important information is available here in the implementation information, which will be required by Fiori consultants to activate this app and to maintain this app, and also to provide the required roles. So for example, if I want to go for configuration, here it will talk about what is the technical name of this particular service. Okay, you can see where exactly these apps are activated, UFI component and all. These are all technical details. This is the OData service which I was talking about. So you'll go to SICF and make sure that these services are activated if you want to use this app. And also, very importantly, as a functional consultant, we need to know which role must be assigned to the end user if he want to see this particular app on his launchpad. Okay, so for each and every app, you will be getting this information. Some of the information is very important for the technical consultants, Fiori consultants, to make sure that the apps are properly activated. But I think from the functional point of view, this is the important information for us. So anytime if you come across that, okay, a particular app is not available to the user when he's logging into his launchpad, you should come here, you should enter the transaction or maybe the name of that app, and you find out which role is responsible for this app. And you make sure that this role is assigned to the end user using transaction SU01. So if you are not authorized to do that, at least you can ask your security or authorization consultant to provide this role to the user. Let me go back to our slides. Okay, so this was about SAP Fiori. In our next session,